Well, thanks to many of you who have asked how my worm bin is doing. It's doing great. In fact, today I think I'm ready for a worm casting harvest. I'm very excited about it, really looking forward to having those wonderful worm castings in my garden. So if you missed the first couple of videos, I'll put a link at the end. But basically, here's my worm bin, and I did make a few modifications since the original video. I did drill some larger holes in the top just so the worms got some more airflow. It was getting a little bit soggy in there. So I did that, but let's take a look and see how they've been doing. Now I've been feeding them now for about 3 months, and it's looking nice and black in here. Now I've been feeding these worms about once a week over the past 3 months, and what I've been doing over the past few weeks is just feeding them over here on this side where you see all these paper bags and this green material over here. So let's kind of peel it back. Now the purpose of that is that hopefully all the worms congregate over here so I can get some of the stuff on the other side harvested. And there looks like that's working. There are quite a few over here. Down in there under the food, I don't know if you can see it, but they're definitely in there. So what we're gonna do is just cover these little guys back up and move over to the other side where it's looking nice and black and ready to try our worm casting harvest. Now, if you don't know what worm castings are, it's just a fancy word for worm poop, basically. They poop out what they eat and it makes wonderful fertilizer for the garden. Now, I'm hoping this will be a really quick and easy way to screen out my castings rather than digging through it manually and getting all the chunks of stuff out. So hopefully it'll make a process that can usually take a long time a whole lot quicker. So I'm just gonna kind of, oh, there's a couple worms down in here, so we'll be careful not to hurt those little guys, but I'm just gonna take a couple of scoops of the material from this side, put it in my little basket here, and you can see there's still lots of chunks of a lot of different things in there. That's probably enough for now. So I'm gonna just take that, and I'm gonna shake it out over here in my other little bin, and we'll see what we get here. So all these big chunks, I'll just throw back in the worm bin. Okay, kind of shake it around. And wow, this stuff looks great. My first little tiny bit here, but you can see, wow, this looks wonderful. It's nice and dark and rich. It's gonna be great for the garden. I'm gonna go ahead and get the rest of this harvested and we'll come back and show you what we got from this whole bin. Okay, so we'll be right back. Well, so far so good. There's a lot of worms in this little scoop, but I'm really happy with how it's going. Don't worry about a couple of worms. Just shake it out, they'll be fine. Even if you get a few worms in your worm castings, all you have to do is pick through it. These little guys are happy. Wow, this is so exciting. And you know what? It wasn't even really that hard to do. All I did was add food like once a week, and after a couple of months, I get this wonderful soil for my garden. It's super easy. So I'm so excited to get this on my tomato plants that I planted a few weeks ago. It's looking really, really good. Well, here we go, my first worm casting harvest. Now I probably got maybe a pound or so of worm castings, and wow, does this stuff look great. This looks way better than anything I've ever bought at the store. Oops, here's a little worm here. We'll just take him out and he's gonna go back in the bin. But anyway, what I'm gonna do is just leave this stuff here in this bucket to kind of dry out. And a little bit really goes a long way with this stuff. It's fabulous. I cannot wait to put it around my tomato plants. So we're gonna leave it in here for, I don't know, a couple of days or so and let it dry out, and then I'll be putting it on my garden. But what I'm gonna do with my worm bin is just rebuild this with some more bedding, some more food, a little bit more compost, and let those worms continue to multiply and chew their way through my bin again. I'll have another worm casting harvest in a couple of months. So if you've never done worm farming, I would really encourage you to do it. Go back and watch my previous two videos. It's super easy. I'm so glad I got started on it. It really feels good to know that my worms are making great soil for my garden. So thanks a lot for watching, and we'll see you next time. There's a bunch of these little guys in here.